Hi, I'm Dr. Mook. I'm with OrthoVirginia, located in our Reston location. I specialize in sports medicine and shoulder surgery. And today I'm going to talk a little bit about frozen shoulder or adhesive capsulitis. I get questions all the time about what a frozen shoulder is. So a frozen shoulder is what we consider an idiopathic condition, meaning we don't know what causes it. But what it is inflammation around the capsule of the shoulder joint. So this is a shoulder joint. This is the ball and socket of the shoulder. What is not seen here is the balloon-like structure that encircles the muscles of the shoulder. And that capsule gets inflamed. And when that capsule gets inflamed, it is painful and it restricts individuals' mobility. This condition is most common in females between the ages of 40 and 60 and has some propensity to affect individuals who have autoimmune conditions like diabetes or thyroid disease. It can also occur after acute injuries where the shoulder is immobilized. And what happens is there's three phases of a frozen shoulder. The first is the inflammatory phase where the shoulder is just painful in nature. Sometimes it mimics other conditions. The second phase is the frozen phase, where the range of motion of the shoulder is significantly restricted and the restriction worsens with time. And the last phase is the thawing phase, and that's where the shoulder loosens up and the pain subsides. The good news about a frozen shoulder is that in almost all circumstances, it's self-limited, meaning it will get better with time. The bad news about a frozen shoulder is that sometimes if it's left unchecked, it can take 2 to 3 years to resolve. So we do not want our patients struggling with pain and limitations of range of motion for that long. So the first step in evaluation is coming into the office and being seen to determine what the cause of your range of motion restriction and pain is. We start with some basic x-rays to make sure you don't have other problems that could be causing your pain. And then the physical exam and history is usually all that's needed to determine if you have a frozen shoulder. Sometimes it's not exactly clear in that circumstance, and an MRI can be helpful. The treatment for a frozen shoulder most of the time is non-operative, so that involves things like a home exercise program to direct you in terms of how to safely move your shoulder with exercises and stretches. Physical therapy is oftentimes a part of that process. Oftentimes, we'll consider a cortisone injection to the shoulder joint, which has been shown in randomized studies to be helpful in aiding in the thawing process. And in some circumstances, intervention is necessary to get you over the top, but we always usually start with non-operative, minimally invasive measures to try to get you there. And only when we have to, we escalate care. So if you have a shoulder that's painful and you've lost your range of motion, come in to see us so we can get it evaluated for you.